We move on to our next speaker, M. Madhivanan. Madhivanan is going to talk to us about the Tamraparani Water Bird Count, a citizen science initiative in southern Tamil Nadu. Madhivanan is a senior research associate at ATRI. For the past 10 years, he's been coordinating this water bird count at Tamraparani with the involvement of local citizens in the landscape.
Hi everyone, I am Madhivanan, working as a senior research associate in ATRI's Agastya Malay Community Conservation Center at South Tamil Nadu. Today I'm here to share with you our 10 years work on Tamraparani Water Bird Count, a citizen science initiative in South Tamil Nadu. Tirunelveli, Tengasi and Thoothukudi districts in southern Tamil Nadu are known to be important area for wintering water birds. There are about 1,300 irrigation tanks in these districts. Many of these tanks are threatened by encroachment, pollution, and so on. ATRI initiated a pilot research study to monitor wetlands and its biodiversity in these regions during the year of 2008. This effort was sustained in the form of citizen-based monitoring titled Tamraparani Water Bird Count in the year of 2011. The main objectives of Tamraparani Water Bird Count are to document spatial distribution, richness, and abundance of water birds in the irrigation tanks, to identify potential sites relevant to conservation of wetlands, and to build a stake of local citizens and the district administration in the conservation of wetlands. The perennial river Tamraparani, which originates in Kalakadamundundurai Tiger Reserve, travels over 120 kilometers in the plains of Tirunelveli, Tengasi and Thoothukudi districts and confluence into Bay of Bengal. The perennial river Tamraparani and its tributaries feeds into 700 plus irrigation tanks in the human dominated landscape. These districts are known as rice bowl of South Tamil Nadu. And these tanks attract large number of water birds during winter. We invite volunteers through printing and social media. We conduct an orientation program to selected volunteers in the first day of the census. The volunteers are divided into 5 to 6 teams. There will be an expert birder in each team. Same wetlands larger than 50 hectares are surveyed over 3 days in 3rd or 4th week of January. The northeast monsoon from mid-October to December affects the water bird abundance in January. So we considered previous year's northeast rainfall for data analysis. Coming to results, this graph illustrates the bird abundance and species richness over a 10-year period from 2011 to 2020. So far, we have recorded 93 water bird species. The most common species are a common coot, cattail egret, lesser whistling duck, northern pintail, little cormorant. The least abundant species are wire-tailed swallow, white-bellied sea eagle, green shank, common red shank, and Baylen's creek. Species richness remains steadily across the years, but we observed huge fluctuations in bird abundance. If we look at the specific species across the years, there was a gradual decrease in spot-billed pelican. The cattail egret remains steadily and shoot up in 2018 and steps down the next years. We could see huge fluctuations in cotton pygmy goose. And the year 2019, there was a sharp increase. The year 2019, there was a sharp increase in the numbers of northern pintail, despite slight fluctuation in other years. Northeast monsoon contributes average of 400 millimeter rainfall in this landscape. Bird abundance was extremely high in the average rainfall years. Bird abundance was not significant during heavy rainfall years, and bird abundance drastically declined during poor rainfall year. Based on our 10-year survey, we have identified 4 heronries and 6 important bird areas in these districts. We are in the process of developing management plan for these sites. The volunteers' participation has gradually increased over the years. The year 2017, we engaged only 27 volunteers due to severe drought. The volunteers came from different background. Most of the volunteers are students. We have identified interested volunteers who were keen on ecology and biodiversity. They became team leaders subsequently. The Vahiculum heronry was discovered by A3 team in the year of 2009. The babul trees planted by Tamil Nadu Forest Department's Social Forestry Division under SITA program in the Vahiculum wetland supports nesting of 20 bird species and 15,000 birds annually. Over a decade, A3 is working with local community, panchayat, students, district administration, forest department, and media. The Social Forestry Division was keen to cut the trees despite of panchayat passing a resolution to protect trees. Person from community filed a public interest litigation in Madurai Bench of Madras High Court and got a favor judgment to retain trees and conserve birds. It took more than 5 years for final judgment, which shows long-term engagement was critical. Overwhelming support by community and media facilitated the protection of the heronry. Youth and children from the villages acted as whistleblowers whenever vandalism was attempted. Based on A3's report, Vahiculum has been shortlisted for Biodiversity Heritage Site under Biological Diversity Act 2002. Vahiculum is also proposed for wetland conservation under Tamil Nadu State Wetland Conservation Authority. This year, we celebrated Tamaravarni Waterbird Carnival to honor 10 years of citizenry participation in Tamaravarni Waterbird Count. This carnival served as an opportunity to bring in attention to the neglected wetlands in the landscape. About 15 different education and outreach programs were conducted in a span of 3 months. More than 5,000 citizens, including students from all parts of Tamil Nadu, participated. The carnival created awareness among local people. We produced several educational materials such as poster on Tamaravarni waterbirds, pocket guides to the wetland plants and birds of Tamaravarni Basin. We also released a bilingual field guide to the wetland birds of South Tamil Nadu. These materials were distributed to local students and interested citizens in the landscape. The major outcomes of Tamaravarni waterbird count are Vahiculum being shortlisted for biodiversity heritage site. Number of volunteers are increasing over years, resulting in stewardship towards wetland conservation. The volunteers who participated in the census formed two nature clubs. They are Pearl City Nature Society in Thoothukudi district and Nellay Nature Club in Tirunelveli district. Now these nature clubs co-organizing the Tamaravarni waterbird count and several education outreach programs in the landscape. A3 has been invited to be part of District Wetland Management Committee, which gives scopes for playing critical role towards conservation of wetlands and associated biodiversity. Work with multiple stakeholders to develop wetland conservation management plan for the selected wetlands. Facilitating the implementation of biodiversity heritage site with stakeholders. Scaling up Tamaravarni waterbird count model to nearby districts. Moving towards vision of linking biodiversity, ecosystem services and culture. We would like to acknowledge the following organizations and individuals for their support. And I thank the organizers of SITSI 2020 for giving me this great opportunity. And I thank the lovely audience who listened to my talk. Thank you all. Stay safe.
Hello. Hi, Madhivanan.
Yes, Madhiv.
Thank you. That was a really good presentation.
Yes,
we have a few. Yeah, we have questions coming in, but they are quite slow. So Nishant wants to know, are the volunteers from nearby areas?
The volunteers mostly from nearby areas, but there are also volunteers came from Bangalore and nearby state, Kerala also. Yes, but from the volunteers from Tamil borders, from all over Tamil Nadu used to participate in the census.
Okay. And how do volunteers get to know about these efforts in like if they are in Bangalore and things? Do you popularize it on portals, birding groups or something?
Yes, actually we popularize it in local printing media. We also use social media for popularizing. Also that Tamil, last year, last few years, our census, the announcement came in eBird group also.
I see. Okay. We have another question from Harsha, who says, since cotton pygmy goose is a resident dabbling duck, can you speculate on why population size fluctuated drastically across the year? Also, how many checklists or counts were made in each month?
Actually, this is a checklist only during January only we used to do. Not monthly okay. checklist we are not doing. This is annual event. Okay. So that's the thing. But here, the irrigation tanks, most often they used to desilting the tanks. So okay. in some of the big tanks, so that they used to dip that soil. So that might affect the cotton pygmy goose population. But interestingly, last few years, we visited our neighboring district, Kanyakumari. So there, we found lots of cotton pygmy goose in Kanyakumari.
Oh, I see.
So there are lots of good vegetation is available in the wetlands. Also, some other good habitat available in Kanyakumari district, I think. So, but in Tinnevelli, Thoothukudi, Thamarabani landscape, it's decreasing.
Okay. So Farida has a question. Have you also been checking the water quality to link bird visitation or decline?
No, but in future we are planning to do it, but for 10 years we didn't do.
Okay, great. Yeah. So I think the questions are coming in slowly. So please do visit the Slack channel and try to respond and interact with attendees as much as you can. We will move on to the next speaker. We have four speakers for this session. So thank you so much, Madhivanan.
Thank you.